Yeah, good, thanks. What have you got there?
Oh, it's an ichthyosaur paddle. It's going in the new dinosaur gallery. It's quite interesting, this one. It shows you this white stuff here. It's all some soft tissue, it's skin and muscle, and it sort of gives you a better idea of what the paddle was like in life.
Okay.
But I don't know if you can see, but this surface here is all broken because originally it was in two pieces.
Oh, well, what happened to the other parts?
Well, when it was discovered, the curator thought it was so important that actually he gave the other half to the Natural History Museum in London.
Okay.
And it's actually on display there in their galleries.
Oh, fantastic.
And because this is going in a new gallery here, we thought we'd better go down and have a look at their half and see how it compares to ours.
Excellent.
So the other week, Becky and I went down just to do that.
We went down to London by coach. When we got to the museum, we went into their marine reptile gallery. We eventually found the specimen. They've got lots of specimens there from barrow-upon-soar. There's a great big wall full of lots and lots of fossil reptiles, and there in the middle of it was the specimen we were after. Met up with Becky, and then we went to unpack the specimen from all the special museum plaster's oak foam we had wrapped it up in, so that we could take it to the museum safely. Once we had unwrapped the specimen, we could then compare it side by side with the one that was down there at the Natural History Museum. Because the specimen is in two halves, we call it a part and counterpart. Perhaps you can think of them as being a bit like two pages in a book, so that when you open the pages, the two specimens are there side by side, but one's a mirror image of the other. The way this happens is normally because where the bones are in the rock is like a plane of weakness, and the rock splits there when you hit it. It's not as if they force the rocks to break there, it's just the way it happened. But it's good because it shows us the structures inside the rock. Our specimen was discovered in 1889, and our curator, Montague Brown, was doing lots of fossil collecting at the time from the Barrow limestone pits. And so when he found this specimen, he gave it the half to the Natural History Museum, and that's documented in our records, and also in the Natural History Museum's records. So we both know from our records this event took place about 120 years ago. This specimen has soft tissue preserved in it. It gives us a better idea of what the flipper was like in life. You can see there's a broad area behind where the soft tissue is, and so the ichthyosaur would have had a much larger surface area on its flipper that it could use when it was swimming. This would have been useful for it because we think it swam by beating its tail from side to side. The flippers at the front would then act a bit like stabilizers, stop it flipping over and help it change direction, pretty much like today's sharks do. This kind of fossil preservation is quite rare, and barrow-upon-soar was the first place where it was recognised. But it's a shame because all the quarries have closed in Barrow, so no one really knows about it anymore. It's there in the old scientific papers, but these days people tend to forget about it, which is a real shame. It was really good going down to London to compare the specimens side by side. One thing in particular we noticed was that the one down there had got part of the head on it, and ours hasn't. Perhaps ours never had the head, or perhaps it wasn't collected in the quarry. It was really useful to go and see, and it was great to take them down and compare them side by side.
So there you go, that's the story of our visit to London. The specimens back together again after 120 years or so.
Oh, fantastic. Oh, thanks so much for telling me the story about that. That's really interesting. I'll really look out for that when it's on back on display in the dinosaur gallery.
Yeah.
I'll leave you to it.
Okay, yeah. Well, see you around,
yeah. Anyway. Cheers, Mark.
Okay, bye.